gas usage through Tuesday must be reduced a minimum of 50% by commercial customers due to the loss of one of the supplementary supplies that New York State Electric and Gas was able to contract for last week. Industrial customers have already been curtailed through Tuesday. Residential customers are being asked to make hard conservation efforts by setting their thermostats at 65 degrees during the day and 55 degrees at night. Cooperation by all classes of customers is imperative at this time.
And do not use your telephone today or tonight to chit-chat.
The telephone company urges those people whose calls are of a strictly social nature to stay off the line so the calls of a medical nature and emergencies can get through. If you must make a call, we ask that you keep it as short as possible. If you do not get dial tone immediately after picking up the receiver, please stay on the line. Do not hang up. You will probably get dial tone after several seconds. And you certainly stand a better chance of getting dial tone than if you hang up and start all over again on a new call. Again, the phone company is urging all callers to postpone conversations. They're not of an urgent nature, so that emergency calls can get through.
States of emergency have been declared in West Seneca, Hamburg, Eden, and Amherst, and the town of Lancaster for the second day in a row. Niagara, Cattaraugus, and Chautauqua County are also hard hit. Plowing operations on state roads in these areas have been suspended. Governor Hugh Carey had ordered the National Guard into the city to help harried city and county snowplow crews clean our streets. Five high-lift guard trucks were airlifted into our area this morning, but even before the storm hit, the guard said it would not start working until Monday. Lackawanna Mayor Kuick called KB News this afternoon to give us this piece of information.
Streets in the city are closed. I also like to add to that in case there is a motorist that is stranded, we advise him to go to the nearest home and call the Lackawanna Police Department, and we'll send someone to pick them up and take them to a place to stay for the night.
And we've just received word that Genesee and Dick Road in Chictawaga is completely blocked. They haven't moved for quite some time. This is KB News at 15 before 5. It's 1 below 0 in our good city, and the wind chill factor is minus 54. AccuWeather says this is what's coming up. The blizzard will continue through tomorrow. The low tonight, 10 below 0. In Ohio, the State Disaster Service Agency is drawing up contingency plans in case whole cities run out of natural gas. Governor James Rhodes is urging Ohioans to get off the streets and highways as soon as possible. And one final item, 22-year-old TV star Freddie Prinze is in critical condition at UCLA Medical Center. Prinze shot himself in the head this morning. KB AccuWeather after this.
No matter what style others wear, I'll never dream of cutting my hair.
My best friend cut her long hair and dared me to cut mine. But I figured I can always cut my hair, but it might take me 10 years to grow it back. I'm glad I didn't. I found Long and Silky from Clairol, the conditioning lotion for long hair.
I'll never dream of cutting my hair. Long and Silky gives me incredible hair.
I had these ratty ends flying out like I didn't care about my hair. Now with Long and Silky, my hair looks bouncy and smooth, feels clean. Plus, it's easy to comb when it's wet, and my ends hardly ever need trimming, so I can grow my hair as long as I like.
I'll never dream of cutting my hair. Long and Silky gives me incredible hair.
Long and Silky. It makes your hair so incredible, you'll never dream of cutting it.
I'll never cut it, ever.
Long and Silky gives me incredible hair.
The exclusive WKBW AccuWeather forecast. Blizzard conditions tonight with snow flurries and snow squalls resulting in heavy accumulations mainly south of the city. Extremely strong winds will gust over 50 miles per hour and will cause severe blowing and drifting snow as temperatures drop to 10 below zero by morning. The wind chill readings will reach 60 below zero. For tomorrow, continued very windy and extremely cold with snow flurries, snow squalls, blowing snow and drifting snow. There'll be little change on Sunday. Temperatures tomorrow will be mainly below zero. The high on Sunday, 5 above. For AccuWeather, this is meteorologist Ray Bass.
Buffalo temperature is 1 below zero. The wind chill factor minus 54. At 6 before 5, I'm Henry Brach, KB Radio News.
Mm-hmm. seller. Standing apart from all other stereo stores, offering you the selected finest in sight and sound from the world over, the most significant breakthroughs in the industry to afford you the best in lasting pleasure.
Just a bit less than 3 hours this afternoon as we lost power to both our downtown studios and Freak Road transmitter site. We have been unable to resume broadcasting through our normally used transmitter. We do, however, have an emergency transmitter. That we are talking to you with now. The best sentence that's ever been constructed. Incidentally, we have that at full power, which is ordinarily reserved for what the government terms daytime broadcast only, but we will be broadcasting at full power for as long as this weather emergency lasts.
And this is Quinn. Now, if you're in your car right now, listen carefully to me. If you are in your car right now, first of all, the New York State Thruway is closed from Syracuse to the Pennsylvania state line, which means any attempt to get on the Niagara section of the Thruway will meet with complete futility. You will be stuck for the night if you try to get on the Niagara section of the Thruway. If you are already on the Niagara section of the Thruway, stay in your car. There are people trying to reach you. Police are trying to reach you with snowmobiles and with cars and whatever, if they can move, but don't, or on foot. But don't panic, okay? If you're afraid, it's okay. Listen, if I was out there, I'd be afraid too. Being afraid is a normal human emotion. Being panicky is not a normal human emotion, and it's something that you can control. And if everybody panics, there's going to be some serious problems, and maybe some people aren't going to come back. So the best thing to do is just sit there, compose yourself, and relax. There are people on the job. It may look pretty bleak right now. If you're going to leave your motor running, make sure that you watch out for carbon monoxide poisoning. Leave your window open a crack to get some fresh air in. If you feel tired or nauseous or you smell exhaust gases, open your window. But just relax. And there are people whose job it is to get to you. It's going to take a while. You're going to be out there for a while. It's going to be a story you're going to tell your grandchildren, but you're going to make it.
Starting Monday, you'll have your chance to win from KBN Purchase Radio. It's the Electronic Tennis Championships, and starting Monday from 6 to 9, you're invited to all three Purchase Radio locations to practice and play to qualify.
The third shift on Sunday night, at which time normal operations will resume. All skilled trades and material department employees who have been scheduled to work on Saturday are asked to report if at all possible. Okay, it's 5 o'clock, 93 WBEN Buffalo.
This is WBEN Radio News. I'm Lou Douglas. A blizzard paralyzes western New York. Motorists are stranded and traffic grinds to a halt. And the Senate begins debate on natural gas emergency legislation. These and other top stories of the hour on WBEN Radio News. Most of the Buffalo area is paralyzed after blizzard conditions whipped through the area shortly before noon today. Strong winds are continuing to whip up blizzard conditions, and blowing and drifting snow has produced numerous whiteouts. Traffic has ground to a halt. Numerous traffic accidents are reported all over western New York, and hundreds of motorists have abandoned their automobiles to search for emergency shelter. Grand Island at this time continues to be marooned, with both the north and south bridges closed down. Motorists at this time are stranded on the bridges in their cars. Also, the New York State Thruway has been shut down from Syracuse to the Pennsylvania state line, as well as the entire Niagara section of the New York State Thruway. Fire halls and police stations throughout the area are offering refuge to stranded motorists, and authorities are urging residents to open up their doors to helpless travelers. Numerous suburban areas around Buffalo have declared snow emergencies. The heavy snowfall appears to be over as far as the storm is concerned right now, but the Buffalo meteorologist George Parrish says the problems resulting from it will continue.
Well, it's not even snowing now. There's no snow falling from the sky. It's all blowing, all snow that fell and blowing around. The problem is the high winds.
How high are the winds?
Well, we've had gusts to 65 miles an hour at Buffalo Airport. Niagara Falls has had gusts to 75 miles an hour. Expecting them to abate some. sometime after midnight, but they will remain strong through the weekend.
The official Buffalo temperature has edged below zero and will remain near that mark through Sunday. Efforts to clear the snow-clogged streets of Buffalo have virtually ground to a halt. The streets commissioner, James Lindner, reports the situation as serious.
We're at a standstill. We've got a monumental traffic jam throughout the city. Ostensibly, all the merchants downtown and all the business managers allowed their people to go home at the same time, it appears. We've got people in the street, but they're not really accomplishing what we'd like them to do. Right now, we have the Department of Transportation in the garage servicing their equipment. My second trick is in the garage servicing their equipment, and we're not going out to lift up size because, at least until the traffic's down, because we can't do anything.
Mr. Lindner says the National Guard is still scheduled to begin assisting the state and city plowing crews on Monday. Attempts to airlift the first National Guard equipment into Buffalo today failed when the weather forced the plane to divert from Niagara Falls to Schenectady. All around Buffalo, workers have been stranded in their places of business because of the storm. One stranded worker at the Thruway Plaza in the town of Cheektowaga, Bert Wagner, tells WBEN Radio News.
The Thruway Plaza is snowed right in. We cannot get up on Broadway, or we can't get over to Walden, can't get to Harlem. So there's going to be a lot of people staying here, at least until the storm lets up a little bit. So if anyone is worried about their people or that work out this way, they should know they're here at the plaza.
Stranded worker Bert Wagner. Among those marooned by the storm was WBEN reporter Marty Gleason, who telephoned from the Cheektowaga Highway garage on Union Road. Marty talked to another person removed there, Isabel Bodner of Williamsville, an employee of American Standard.
I left the office at 12:45, and I've been here since 3 o'clock. And I want to express my appreciation to the superintendent of the highway department who sent the men out to the car to guide us back here. They're serving us coffee, and it's just wonderful.
What kind of storm has this been for you?
It's the worst that I can remember. I was never stranded before in my life.
Isabel Bodner of Williamsville. Meanwhile, at the Greater Buffalo International Airport, no flights are coming in or out at this hour since visibility is near zero. And this just in, the New York State Thruway has now been closed from Amsterdam, 30 miles west of Albany, to the Pennsylvania state line. The Thruway Authority says that blowing and drifting snow has forced the closing of the superhighway. Now a 323-mile stretch of the Thruway is closed down. The Niagara Mohawk Power Corporation reports that 5,000 customers over a wide area of the Niagara Frontier in Genesee County are now without power. All crews are out and attempting to get to the problem areas. The utility asks that only customers without electric service call. All other calls should be held off until the first of the week. New York telephone company officials are urging area residents to avoid using the telephone for social calls. Spokesman James Rhodes said that the phones should be used for emergencies only until the storm abates. New York State Electric and Gas in Lockport is appealing to all commercial and public customers in Erie, Niagara County, and Orleans County to further curtail the use of natural gas. New York State Electric and Gas has requested that natural gas consumption be reduced to a minimum of 50%. The latest problem developed after the Brooklyn Union Gas Company canceled a contract for gas they planned on supplying to New York State Electric and Gas. Brooklyn Union claims they now need the fuel for their own purposes. WBEN News Time, 6 minutes past 5 o'clock.
At Pavillion, some buses are out returning children to their homes. They say the conditions aren't as bad in Pavillion as elsewhere. Other children are being held at the school. Pavillion is also described as okay. Taking a look at road conditions, city police ask that there be no driving at all. The police want you to stay where you are. Streets are in, quote, miserable condition.
Welcome now to the listening bonus edition of Cocktail Time. The short is one of the week. Eric from Class 5 is some of the prettiers of Valentina's El Nino Judio.
Anybody who's stranded in the area. There are 60 cars stalled at the William and Fillmore area. Stay away from that. Let's see. All 7 AM&A stores will be closed tomorrow. And the New York State Thruway between Amsterdam and the Pennsylvania line The New York State Thruway, in other words, our thruway for everybody who can hear my voice right now, for all intents and purposes, the thruway is closed. The New York State Thruway is closed. Now, here's the important part. The Niagara section is closed. The state police have reported that along the Niagara section, there may be entrances that look like you can get on it and get away with it. The fact is, you cannot. If you get on the Niagara section of the thruway, pal, you're on it for the duration, because you are not going to get off. Now, those of you who are on the Niagara thruway or section of the thruway right now, state troopers and other law officers are attempting to rescue you, and they will. There are some injured motorists. They're going to help them first. All I can tell you is if you are stranded in your car, remain calm. If you let yourself panic, there's a chance you could get killed out there. And I don't want to make you panic, but that's the truth. So the thing to do is to arrest your fear. It's normal to be afraid. Don't worry about that. I'd be afraid if I was out there, too. I'm here, and I'm afraid. I look outside that window and go, yay. But look, just relax, okay? There are people out there. Their job is to get to you and to rescue you, and it's going to happen, okay? You're going to be all right. Just relax. Make sure you don't, if you feel like you're smelling carbon monoxide, well, carbon monoxide doesn't have a smell, but it usually comes along with other automotive fumes. So if you start smelling fumes, make sure you open your window, get some fresh air in there. Watch out for that. Watch out for frostbite. Keep your radio on KB and relax, because we're going to get you out of there. Just relax. The entire town of Cheektowaga is shut down. And my entire town of Cheektowaga has been shut down for years. The entire town of Cheektowaga is shut down and isolated by the storm. All residents of Western New York must stay indoors. That's it. Nobody is allowed out unless it's an emergency. Okay? And KB Radio News will have an expanded news report, a wrap-up of everything that's going on at 5:45. That's exactly 35 minutes from right now, and I'll also have a complete list of schools that will be closed on Monday.
Cabbages, the music experience.
This week at Cabbages, all the hottest hits are on super sale. Listen, now at $3.99, Gary Wright's Light of Smiles.
Manfred Mann, Blinded by the Light.
Leon Redbone, Double Time.
Rod Stewart's Tonight's the Night.
$3.99 for ABBA featuring Dancing Queen.
Emmy Lou Harris, Luxury Liner.
Gene Lupati, Imaginary Voice.
$3.99 for the Ohio Players' Greatest Hits.
Genesis, Wind and Wuthering.
And on and
just
on.
$3.99 for the hottest hits. Plus, now in stock, the new David Bowie, Low, a $7.98 list. Now just $4.99 at Cabbages. Plus, Streisand and Christopher. A Star is Born, an $8.98 list, now $5.99. These are but a few of the specials this week at Cabbages.
Whoa, Cabbages, the music experience. Cabbages, the music experience.
If there isn't a Cabbages near you, get moving! No matter where you live, you can have a free Florida vacation for two. 4 days and three nights at a glamorous Florida oceanfront hotel. Yours free with the purchase of any new or used car from a participating dealer. Hurry. Free vacations are limited and available only at Colonial Ford, Niagara Street, Tonawanda, Mid-City Dodge, Walden Avenue, Cheektowaga, Manorina Motors, Delaware Avenue in Tonawanda, Delaware Motors for Volvo and Subaru, Delaware Avenue, Buffalo, and Ray Wiles Chevrolet, Millersport Highway. Free Florida vacations while they last.
George Hamberger, WKBW.
Well, again, if you're in your car and you're out on the Niagara section of the thruway, or you're stranded wherever you are, don't be afraid. Just relax. This is a great adventure. Miserable adventure, but you can tell your grandchildren about it, and you'll survive it if you just relax. There are state police and law enforcement officials whose job it is to get to you, and they're working on that right now, and they'll do it too.
Ordered by February 9th for delivery later, or bought from stock by February 28th, 1977.
Also, this offer now applies to new Chevrolet Series 5 Love trucks bought from stock by February 28, 1977. You get the cash bonus no matter how good a deal you get from your Chevrolet dealer. And you can apply the $200 to your down payment or get a check direct from Chevrolet. Remember, $200 cash bonuses on Chevrolet Chevette, Vega, Monza Town Coupe, and Series 5 Love trucks. Don't buy any new small car or truck until you see your Chevrolet dealer. When somebody offers you $200, take it.
Here's a look at the weather for Rochester, and it's not good. It's 3 degrees currently, minus 16 Celsius. There's a blizzard warning continuing for tonight. Westerly winds at 20 to 45 miles an hour with higher gusts at times will produce near zero visibility in blowing and drifting snow. Winds will diminish to 15 to 30 tomorrow. Bitterly cold with snow tapering off to flurries and possible local squalls tonight. Accumulation 2 to 4 inches overnight. Below 5 to 10 below zero. Continued windy and cold with occasional flurries likely Saturday, Saturday night and Sunday, with the high tomorrow near 5 above and the low tomorrow night about zero. The high Sunday, 10 to 15 degrees. And the chance of snow is put at 80% tonight, 70% tomorrow, and 60% tomorrow night. It's 3 degrees in Rochester, minus 16 Celsius. That's the news. I'm Dick Dimecco.
Well, Dick, the 5 o'clock news was brought to you by Chevrolet and your local Chevrolet dealer, who also bring you Motor Trend's Car of the Year, the new Chevrolet Caprice Classic.
This is Dick Favada, the voice of Snow Ridge Ski Resort in Turin, New York, bringing you our ski conditions as of Friday morning, January 21st, and a forecast of the weather conditions we expect over the weekend. Well, the word is snow this morning. Lots of it on our 20-inch base. We've had a foot of snow in the last week, and our big cats are out right now grooming the slopes. Conditions are really excellent for the weekend, and when we say excellent, we mean excellent. Most of us are glad to see a pleasant warming trend. Our weatherman, Liv Lansing, tells us we can expect some warmer weather with temperatures in the 20s and a chance of snow flurries throughout the weekend. Now and then, I take a little survey riding one of the lifts and ask someone why they ski Snow Ridge. Good snow conditions is a frequent answer, and then people often add, you know, it kind of seems that I have more fun at Snow Ridge. This is Dick Favada for Snow Ridge Ski Resort in Turin, New York, where the fun's at.
During the next 30 seconds, I want you to listen very carefully because this is a carpet sale that will not be repeated. 137 rolls of wools, nylons, antrons, and nylon polyester, originally priced at $18.99 a square yard, will clear for just $4.99. Believe it, just $4.99, but only at Max Pies and only tomorrow. Max Pies one-day carpet clearance, special store hours, 11 a.m. till 6 p.m. at Max Pies Monroe Avenue and Westridge Road. Whatever you do, don't miss it.
Welcome back to the David A. Senett Electric Radio Program. What a night. What a day. It is really howling out there. We're going to have a bunch of other cancellations coming up. We'll have mind benders, too, because you're stuck in traffic anyway. Might as well have something to do. And we will keep you apprised about the weather conditions and traffic conditions as best we can. We get situations like this where the telephone lines get kind of tied up. And we'll just try to do... everything we can is what we'll do. A little music along the way, too, wouldn't be bad. Miss Esther Phillips.
New York State Thruway 50, exit 50 through exit 55 is closed. And the Niagara section of the Thruway is closed, plus the Grand Island bridges are closed. And life is pretty tedious. Just occurs to me that we have a bunch of vehicles that are sitting out in front of our radio station here on Elmwood Avenue, and a lot of folks are wandering around their vehicles and everything else, and if you folks are cold, you might as well bop on in here, because we got, if one thing, we got plenty of heat for the time being anyway. All right? Okay, keep that in mind. Okay, now we'll check out some other cancellations for you and closings and all that other stuff in just a moment at 93 WBEN. Standby.
River dance,
Charlie, what are you
so happy about?
Well, I'm thinking about my trip to Rome. Arrivederci Roma. I'll fly from Buffalo to New York, then Alitalia 747 jet to Rome with great Italian food on the plane. Mamma mia, 7 days in Rome. Beautiful. The Colosseum, the Forum, the Via Veneto, sidewalk cafes, and I'll be staying at the Savoy Hotel.
Great! When you leaving, Charlie?
March 17th, St. Patrick's Day. I hope.
You hope?
Yeah, I haven't won the trip yet.
You mean you expect to win a vacation like that? Come on!
Sure, it's called OTB's Roman Holiday for Two, so I put my free entry in at OTB. I didn't have to buy anything. They'll draw the winner on February 28th, and I think I'm going to win. A positive thinker, that's me.
Charlie, you have a great idea. Excuse me.
Where are you going, Pat?
To OTB, Charlie. Where else? Arrivederci, Roma. You see, I figure you don't have to be a Roman to win a trip to Rome.
Okay, we are monitoring the Buffalo Amateur Radio Repeaters Association, and we have been told that Sheridan Drive is just a big parking lot. And north of Youngman at 290 is backed up. And again, guys, I remind you, Niagara County is in a state of emergency. If you're on the air or if you're on the road there, you're going to be in violation. It's open for emergency vehicles only. Mike Slepian is downtown. And Michael, I have a feeling that you'll probably be listening, and I wonder if in the next couple of minutes you can come up and give us a report on what the conditions downtown might be through the Buffalo Amateur Radio Repeaters Association. Okay, we'll be monitoring that. All right, let's go to Lou Douglas in WBEN Newsroom.
This is Lou Douglas in the WBEN Newsroom. I hope to be talking to Mayor Stanley Makowski. He has a special announcement. We haven't got the mayor. All right, thank you. The information from the mayor's office is, and we will have the mayor on the phone, is that Mayor Makowski has requested, or rather has received word from Governor Kerry that he has requested President Carter to declare Buffalo in a state of emergency and make it available for federal funds. We hope to have Mayor Makowski on the phone. We just received that news in the WBEN newsroom.
Okay, Lou, thank you so much. Mayor Makowski expecting to have the President of the United States declare Buffalo a state of emergency, and that would make it available for federal funds that would help us with the cleanup after all this takes place. Attention all employees, Harrison Radiator Division, Lockport and Buffalo plants. Due to weather conditions, second and third shifts have been canceled for today. Friday, January 28th, normal operations will resume on Monday unless employees are otherwise notified. An important message from National Fuel Gas. All residential customers are urged to turn their thermostats back 65 degrees by day, 55 degrees at night. All stores, offices, and commercial buildings must have temperatures of 55 degrees at all times. It is urgent because weather forecasters predict continued sub-zero temperatures through Monday. We must save more gas now to prevent prolonged closings. Set home thermostats 65 degrees by day, 55 degrees at night. Commercial buildings, 55 degrees at all times. We have other cancellations that are continuing to stream in, and I'll get them to you as quickly as I can. Attention Buffalo Evening News readers and carriers. Because of the storm, no home delivery of tonight's edition of the Buffalo Evening News. Repeat, no home delivery of tonight's edition of the Buffalo Evening News. And we'll get to the cancellations right after this.
A few months ago, upstate milk cooperatives introduced Western New York to Nutrish, the new milk with a new benefit. How's Nutrish doing? Here's what Mrs. Nancy Smith of Hamburg told us.
My son Jeffrey is 16 months old. He's always had an allergic problem to milk, and his formula that he was on was getting more and more expensive and harder to find. Then I heard about Nutrish. He hasn't had any bad reactions to it. The doctors feel that it's taken the place of formula very well.
Neighborhoods today to get an idea. Tiff?
Sherwood Road in Overbrook is lined with beautiful homes and notable residents like Council President George Schwartz and City Representative Al Gaudiosi. Many of their neighbors I dropped in on, like Nora Serpenti, said they weren't convinced there was a gas shortage, but Serpenti and her neighbors are lowering the thermostat.
And it's all because people are on the phone yapping to one another. Don't do that, because we need the telephone system for communication of important information like ambulances and fire equipment and doctors and whatever. The New York State Thruway from Amsterdam to the Pennsylvania state line, the entire New York State Thruway within the sound of my voice right now, is closed. That includes the entire Niagara section. And I imagine it goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway, that the North and South Grand Island bridges are closed. North and South Grand Island bridges are closed. And traffic is limited tonight to emergency vehicles only. If you have gotten home, stay there. If you are still moving around in your car, and you don't think you can make it home, there are some shelters where you can go. And I'll have a list of those for you in just a few minutes. If you are stranded on the Niagara section, be calm, relax. There are people right now who are working their brains out trying to get to you. And they will. Just watch out for carbon monoxide poisoning and for frostbite. And don't get out of your car. Just relax and think about what a great story this will be to tell your grandchildren, and everybody will be okay.
This is your captain speaking. We'd like to welcome you aboard Club 747. With Monday night's oldie nights, with Big Wheelie and Buddy Ralamade in the booth. Ladies, we offer free boarding passes and you get oldie prices. Tuesday, special disco night with Marty Angelo. Wednesday, music for Andy night, boogie bump, disco, and oldies all night. Thursday, disco dance night, free lessons from Richard and Francine. It's Captain Disco in the booth Thursday through Saturday. Thank you for flying Club 747.
At the Executive, Buffalo's number one live entertainment capital, the home of the stars, now appearing Joe Savage. Plus the road at the Executive, Genesee Street across from the airport. Relax in the 24-hour Planes and Aces coffee shop. Starting next Tuesday, it's the Platters.
Heavenly shades of night are falling, it's twilight time.
Now appearing at the Executive, it's Joe Savage plus the road. You never know who you're going to meet at the Executive.
Okay, here's an announcement from National Fuel Gas. All residential customers are urged to turn thermostats back to 65 degrees by day and 55 degrees at night. All stores, offices, and commercial buildings must have temperatures at 55 degrees at all times. It is urgent because weather forecasters predict continued sub-zero temperatures through Monday. We must save more gas now to prevent prolonged closings. Set home thermostats at 65 by day and 55 by night. Commercial buildings at 55 degrees at all times. And if you are calling WKBW to cancel a social or civic or organizational activity, don't bother, because we have canceled it for you. All social, organizational, and civic activities are canceled in Western New York.
This afternoon when I went on the air, the whole problem with Niagara County right now is absolute snow, snowing, blowing, drifting, dangerous. We talked about a nurse before that is a registered nurse, and if I can find that out, I'd like to keep these separate if possible. Put your thumb through there and see if you can find the registered nurse. I have another registered nurse at a different location who is kind enough to call in. 2918 McCoon Avenue. Anyone in that area who may require medical help should give her a call. Or...
Friends, when it comes to cars, dealers come and dealers go. But with customers who know their deal, it's been Freer's for years. Yes, for 46 years, Freer Chevrolet has been the savings and service supremacy dealer.
It's at least a minus 70. Degrees outside. Minus 70 when you consider the wind chill factor. Now the forecast, blizzard warning continue tonight. Westerly winds 20 to 45, higher gusts. Near zero visibility, winds diminishing 15 to 30 tomorrurBitterly cold, occasional snow flurries tonight. 1 to 3 inches overnight, low 5 to 10, below zero. Continued cold and windy and occasional snow flurries likely Saturday night and Sunday. Low Saturday night, about zero, the high Saturday near 5. High Sunday, 10 to 15. And again, our temperature stands at a minus 1. And it's 5:30 at 93 WBEN. And here's Lou Douglas and the latest headlines.
Buffalo Mayor McCoskey told WBEN News minutes ago that he has requested and the governor has asked the President of the United States to declare Buffalo a disaster area. Erie County would also benefit from such an order if it is issued by President Carter. Buffalo is in the midst of one of its worst winters in history and is now in the grip of blizzard-like conditions which have paralyzed much of the Niagara frontier. The New York State Thruway is now closed from Amsterdam, 30 miles east of Albany, to the Pennsylvania state line. Also closed is the entire Niagara section of the Thruway. Hundreds of motorists have been forced to abandon their automobiles throughout the area and seek emergency shelter. All roadways in Niagara County have been declared in a state of emergency. The chief county law enforcement officer, James Ferry, said that vehicles will be in violation of state law. Only emergency vehicles will be permitted until the lifting of the emergency sometime in the next 36 hours. 22 persons are missing following a flash fire which swept an old hotel on the Minnesota-North Dakota border this morning. The blaze was fed by 45-mile-an-hour winds with a temperature at 25 degrees below zero. A major blizzard is raging across the lower Great Lakes with winds of up to 75 miles an hour blowing snow and reducing visibility to near zero. Emergencies have been declared in several southwestern lower Michigan counties. Frigid air is continuing to rush into Ohio. The combined effect of the Arctic temperatures and the strong winds produced wind chill factors between 40 and 60 degrees below zero across the region. The index dropped to 70 below across the upper Mississippi Valley and the northern plains. Schools and businesses have been urged to close, and in Chicago alone, 500,000 children stayed home from school. Freddie Prinz was on the operating table for 2 hours today after shooting himself in the head. A spokesman at UCLA Medical Center said the hospital's switchboard was jammed with phone calls from well-wishers shortly after the comedian's condition was announced and that cards and flowers are pouring into that hospital. And repeating, Buffalo Mayor Stanley Mikowski told WBEN News that Governor Hugh Carey is requesting President Carter to declare Buffalo and Erie County a major disaster area. The mayor said that such a disaster declaration would provide federal funds for the area for a snow cleanup. Those are top stories. We'll have further details. This is Lou Douglas.
All right, we're moving right along as best we can. Let me start passing some of these things along to you so that we can kind of catch up. All right, we have a bloodmobile on a blood run to Mercy Hospital, disabled at South Park Avenue and Hamburg Street. Now, we are taking these things as they come and, as they show some priority. Although the University of Buffalo Law School is closed, the Marine Bar Review course will be held on schedule at 6 p.m. at the law school. You've got to be kidding me. Well, I guess that's what they're going to do. All right, Skajakwita District Scout Dinner Dance at the Townhouse Restaurant, scheduled for tomorrow night, is canceled until further notice. The William Hanger Company offering sanctuary for downtown stranded persons who need shelter and food. We had that a little while ago. They expect to be open all night, and they will be closed Saturday and Sunday, but hopefully they will reopen Monday at the regular time. Hinwood Restaurant, open for stranded motorists. Have some coffee. That's at Elmwood and Hinman. Both Pitt Petrie stores, 378 Delaware and Main near Harlem, will be closed on Saturday. If you're stranded on Grand Island, we have a number of private homes that have opened their doors to extend a welcome to you. 1121 Baseline between Love Road and Gerald. There's food, lodging, and sleeping accommodations. And just drop in. Private home to stranded individuals at 125 Richmond Avenue near Summer, upstairs. Employees. Corporate headquarters Twin Fair will remain at the office until it's not so bad, so don't worry. Graphic Controls has several hundred employees safe and sound in their building, so don't worry about them. F&N Burt Company, Walden Avenue, Cheektowaga, reports most employees staying overnight. They're all okay. All Gen stores will not be open tomorrow. William Grange encourages its employees who've attempted to get home to come back to the company if you can. Seneca Bailey residents who become stranded, oh, they will provide shelter there. Okay. Dunlop Tire and Rubber Company, Sheridan and River Road, town of Tonawanda, New York, recommending all employees stay in the plant until the weather begins to improve. Provisions have been made for food and shelter. Chevrolet Tonawanda Forge Plant has canceled second and third shift operations for tonight. Maintenance employees should continue to report for work as scheduled for weekend overtime. Regular operations will resume next week with the light up
crew Sunday night. PG Steel Products, Cheektowaga closed and will resume normal operations on Monday. All offices, Western New York Savings Bank closed on Saturday, opening Monday morning. Abel's Bagels canceling second and third shifts today. All shifts canceled Saturday. Production will resume Sunday, weather permitting. Supervisors will advise. Let's see, BC Automotive closed till Monday. Schumann Plastics, all shifts canceled until Monday. Spalding Fiber, Tonawanda, second and third shifts, all work canceled until Sunday midnight. Erie County Savings Banks closed today and tomorrow. Trico Products, all three plants, Buffalo areas, closed. Normal operations expected to begin in the evening of the third shift Sunday at midnight unless otherwise advised.
In order to maintain supply to homes, your cooperation is essential. Right now, in conserving gas, turn your thermostat down, way down. Use hot water sparingly. Eliminate all non-essential use of gas, including outdoor lamps. To repeat, a severe gas supply emergency exists, and industrial and commercial customers have been asked to stop the use of gas in New Jersey. To avoid a complete shutdown of gas service to homes in your area, you must reduce your use of gas immediately in every possible way.
WCAU Radio News time is 23 minutes before the hour of 6 o'clock, and of course, exacerbating this confounding, I guess, really, the energy situation is the weather. It's incredible how bad this weather is going to be.
Well, it's a triple form number coming our way. High wind, traveler's advisory, and extreme cold. And in addition to that, an energy shortage. What a compounding that is.
Center at the foot of Main Street, they're in the building, along with other people who use the building for emergency shelter. And they do have hot soup down there. They, you know, they have a commissary and they have restaurants in that building. So they have enough food to last for about 3 days.
My goodness. Stuck in that building with all those girls that work in the bank. Oh, I love it. Well, anyhow, we'll have more information for you. If you're wondering about a civil or a civic or social organizational kind of thing tonight that you were going to go to and you wonder if it's canceled or not, it's canceled. Take my word for it. Whatever it is, it ain't going on.
Shadows fill my darkened room. I fantasize about when and whom and wait. Future, can't you happen fast? Make me finish growing.
Growing up has a way of taking care of problems, including acne. But if you've got acne now, you need help now. Neutrogena Acne Cleansing Soap can help. It does two things your dermatologist wants you to do. Keep your skin clean and dry of excess oil. So until you outgrow acne, try Neutrogena Acne Cleansing Soap.
Halfway in a woman's world.
Neutrogena Acne Cleansing Soap, the intelligent way to cope with acne.
This is Irv Weinstein. Buffalo declared a disaster area. The story on Channel 7 Eyewitness News film at 6 o'clock.
Gary Wright is weaving electric dreams again.
Born in February, you were always very shy.
Other days till 5, closed Sundays. Visit the great country store with a near statewide reputation for selling the best of the most for the least. Mount Morris Furniture, Mount Morris, New York.
Thank you, Waldo. The 11th annual Lincoln First Basketball Tournament will hold court at the War Memorial on Saturday, that's tomorrow, and Friday and Saturday, February 4th and 5th. See Brockport State, St. John Fisher, RIT, Alfred, Geneseo State, Hobart, Roberts, Wesleyan, all battle for the 1977 crown. A triple header starting at 5:30 each evening. Advance tickets, $150 at any Lincoln First office. Tickets at the door, $250. So be on hand Saturday, January 29th, for the opening action at the War Memorial. Not action at the War Memorial. Okay, see, we have 19 minutes before 6. Oh, at 6 o'clock, of course, regardless of the weather, the blizzards, and all the catastrophes we're having now, Direct Line continues apace. And story producer Peter Weil is in our studio. Peter, what's going to happen tonight?
All right, well, there was some hassle with Direct Line today because of the heavy overload on telephones throughout
our area. You had trouble getting lines?
We've had some troubles, but what this means is that we've only booked two interviews for today. but they are going to be interesting ones. Let me tell you, the first one should be of special interest. We're talking to the national secretary of a group called Priests for Equality, which is advocating ordination of Catholic priests by women. In other words, that women become
priests. Four women,
in face of the Vatican's pronouncement yesterday.
Ah.
And we're going to be talking about that. Then we have something really special. We have something absolutely
delightful. Oh, I got to hear this one. I'm looking over your shoulder.
You heard me laughing earlier this afternoon. I was laughing because I was talking to this guy that we'll be talking with a little bit later on. His name is Stan Lemkuhl, and he can do the most incredible sound effects just with his voice that I have ever heard. Unbelievable. And he is going to give us a good sampling of his talent.
No paraphernalia, just his
voice? Nothing, nothing. And you won't believe it. It is one of the funniest interviews I have ever imagined in my life. And the guy should be really delightful. And we'll be talking with him today. So that comes up at 6 o'clock. And
at 11.05.
At 11.05.
Righto. Okay.
And don't miss it. It's hilarious.
Oh, no, I will not miss that one. That's going to be something else. All right, that's direct line at 6 o'clock and 11.05 this evening, both. Oh, that's going to be something else. I think we're pretty well caught up on our cancellations and so on, and our weather stuff. The blizzard warning continues in effect tonight. We're going to have westerly winds 20 to 45 with a chance of higher gusts, and that's going to produce near zero visibility in blowing and drifting snow. Winds diminishing to 15 to 30 tomorrow, if you can call it diminishing. Bitterly cold with snow tapering into snow flurries and possible local squalls tonight. Accumulation maybe 2 to 4 inches overnight. And bitter and 60% Saturday night. I'm going to go home and hide under the bed. What I'm going to do. Blizzard conditions right now. And 3 degrees above zero. Pressure rising. And wind west-southwest, 29 miles an hour, gusting to around 39 miles an hour. So, put on your long woolen gauchies and just enjoy the wonderful weather we have in upstate New York.
Do I have small news for you? The greatest little beer in the world is here. Bud 7-Ounce, one Beechwood-aged handful of the king of beers. Available now wherever you buy Bud. Bud 7-Ounce. When you want a lot of quality, a little at a time. Oh, yeah. Anheuser-Busch, headquarters, St. Louis, Missouri.
All right. Thank you, Ed. It is 16 before 6 now on the David A. Senate Electric Radio Program. You know, friends, we've been telling you about a great place for quality furniture.
On Main is open for stranded people. St. Luke Lutheran Church at Maryvale and Union Road in Cheektowaga is open for anyone stranded. The entire town of Cheektowaga is shut off to all traffic. The whole town is closed. If you are in your car and you are stuck somewhere and you have a CB unit, you may try to reach some of the base units around the area, especially if you live in Cheektowaga and you can't get home and you're stuck in your car, try channels 19 and 20. Channels 19 and 20, if you have a CB in your car, the base units, you can reach base units in Cheektowaga and in some of the areas that are closed off, and they will patch you through on the phone, or at least they will deliver a message. Wheatfield Carborundum employees are stuck at the plant. They can't get out, but they're okay. Let's see. I've got a couple of places here where you can crash if you're downtown and you want someplace to stay, if I can find them. Buffalo Evening News, deliveries have been canceled. Kmart stores in Buffalo are closed. The second shift at Fisher-Price in Medina has been canceled. All social events in the city have been canceled. I'll have those places where you can go if you're stranded downtown right after Henry Brach with our extended newscast. Henry?
The story of a storm. I'm Henry Brach. We've been in contact with an awful lot of people since the blizzard began late this morning, and here is their story on tape. We begin with a statement by Bud Zubler of the mayor's office.
Mayor McCoskey has been informed that Governor Kerry has asked President Carter to declare Buffalo a major disaster area. This would not mean immediate relief from the storm. However, it would make Buffalo available for federal assistance for cleanup efforts after the storm subsides.
The wind continues to whip up a devil's dance with the snow,
and we have a report on conditions on the roads of Erie County.
Erie County, we're advising no travel whatsoever. They're very hazardous, extremely hazardous. Visibility is zero, complete zero at times. There must be 1,000 abandoned vehicles and 100 accidents in this county that are unaccounted for.
Niagara County is also being clobbered at this time. A sheriff's department spokesman there tells KB News.
Very, very treacherous. Everything is all blacked in. We got all our cars stopped. There's no traffic requested at all.
Plowing on all state roads in western New York has been suspended.
Jim Weld with the State Department of Transportation would like to advise that we have suspended snow plowing and sanding operations until conditions improve in Chautauqua, Erie, and Niagara counties. Visibility is so poor that the drivers are unable to operate their vehicles safely. Motorists are advised not to travel until the weather moderates. The state will resume operations as soon as possible.
And AAA has been buried today.
This is Jerry Ryan from the Automobile Club. Right now, as of about an hour ago, we had to pull all trucks off the roads in Erie County, so we are not servicing anyone. We suggest people just stay home. If you do get stranded, give us a call. We can get to you whenever we can get the trucks on the road, but you're going to have to find a warm place to stay.
And in City Hall. And now we have that tape on where you can go to get shelter.
Various community centers will be open for any stranded motorists or anybody who is out any facilities in their home. The various centers are Carmichael Community Center on South Park and Letty, Hennepin Community Center on Bailey and Ludington, Delavan Moselle Community Center on Delavan Avenue, Neighborhood House 1 on Clinton and Gorski, Neighborhood House 3 on South Park and Tift, JFK Community Center on Hickory Street.
City Hall was closed early this afternoon, and many workers and citizens decided to ride out the storm there. We talked to His Honor, Mayor Stanley Mikowski.
The statement on the state of the city today, it's really a bad situation. And I just spoke with Commissioner Lindner, and although we have the Department of Transportation, the State Department of Transportation equipment here and the manpower, we cannot fully utilize them because of the poor visibility, number one, and secondly, many of our streets are jammed with vehicles. And until we can get this kind of cooperation from our citizens, I know it's difficult not to go out on our streets. We will not be able to fully utilize the equipment that came here from either the National Guard or the Department of Transportation.
Like the rest of the area, the city of Lackawanna is buried under a mantle of white. Here is Mayor Kuick of the Steel City.
Okay, this is Mayor Kuick calling from the city of Lackawanna. I've been informed by our traffic director, Captain Violani, that the following streets in the city of Lackawanna are closed. Martin Road, South Park, Hamburg Turnpike. Abbott Road is moving very, very slowly, and what we would like to do is urge the people to stay off the streets and just stay in the home. Streets in the city are closed. I also like to add to that that in case there is a motorist that is stranded, we advise him to go to the nearest home and call the Lackawanna Police Department, and we'll send someone to pick them up and take them to a place to stay for the night.
To the south of our city, the situation is bad and getting worse. Town of Hamburg Police Chief Robert Williams told KB News.
Plus, no travel. No travel in the town of Hamburg due to the emergency situation. Visibility is zero. Vehicles are becoming involved with our emergency vehicles attempting to get through. And the community at the present time is marooned.
Police Chief Warren Keller of West Seneca phoned in to tell us that his town is under a state of snow emergency.
All motorists are advised to stay out of West Seneca, not to try to use any of the highways because the highways are all closed down, and visibility is zero, and we're at a standstill right at this moment. We can't move.
Another snow emergency comes from the town of Amherst. Here is Supervisor Jack Sharp.
We've declared a state of snow emergency in Amherst because of poor visibility. Our roads are open, but the visibility is absolutely zero out here. We have had many accidents on many streets, so we're asking everybody to stay off the roads and to stay home and no unnecessary travel in the town until further notice. This is a snow emergency, and we just have no visibility. We cannot possibly handle the situation until this wind lets up and the visibility improves.
Down deep in the traditional snow belt to the south of the city sits the town of Evans. The white blindness hit there early, and Supervisor Catalano made this appeal.
All right, the town of Evans, the town of Brant, the village of Angola are in a state of emergency. We have a total whiteout. We want no travel and only emergency phone calls.
The story was the same from Eden.
According to the orders of town supervisor William Beasley, the town is in a state of snow emergency.
Crews from our major utilities are out in the blizzard doing a job, trying to restore power. Here is what Niagara Mohawk is doing.
Niagara Mohawk has about 5,000 customers in the western New York service area without service at this time. Buffalo in the suburbs is experiencing trouble, as well as the Batavia, Oakfield, Hamlin, and the southern section of the town of Cambria in the Niagara area. In addition, we have about a couple hundred customers out in Angola. Niagara Mohawk urges customers only with power outages to call Niagara Mohawk at this time. We have all crews working, but they're experiencing extreme difficulty in getting to all the job sites at this time.
Things are tough at New York State Gas and Electric, too. Here's a message for the area they serve. Well, we'll be getting that message to you in just a minute. But right now, New York Telephone Company has something to say.
New York Telephone Company urges those people whose calls are of a strictly social nature to stay off the line so the calls of a medical nature and emergencies can get through. If you must make a call, we ask that you keep it as short as possible. If you do not get dial tone immediately after picking up the receiver, please stay on the line. Do not hang up. You will probably get dial tone after several seconds. And you certainly stand a better chance of getting dial tone than if you hang up and start all over again on a new call. Again, the phone company is urging all callers to postpone conversations. They're not of an urgent nature, so that emergency calls can get through.
New York State Electric and Gas is appealing to all its commercial and public natural gas customers in eastern Niagara County and Orleans County to further curtail their use of natural gas immediately and or to close as soon as possible. Gas usage through Tuesday must be reduced a minimum of 50% by commercial customers due to the loss of one of the supplementary supplies that New York State Electric and Gas was able to contract for last week. Industrial customers have already been curtailed through Tuesday. Residential customers are being asked to make hard conservation efforts by setting their thermostats at 65 degrees during the day and 55 degrees at night. Cooperation by all classes of customers is imperative at this time.
With the temperatures plunging below zero and the winds the way they are, you are in constant danger of frostbite if you go outside. If you do feel the bite of the cold, here is what you can do.
In the case of severe frostbite, there is a large blister appearing on the surface. And in the case of a blister, they are not to be broken. And the entire thickness of the skin, the freezing is much deeper. The tissue destruction will be severe, and they should get in touch with a doctor. The more common form of frostbite, which will affect more people, will be a frost appearance on the skin in either a white coloration or possibly yellow. In this case, they have found recently that it is not recommended that victims of frostbite rub in any way the frostbitten area, because that can cause tissue damage. The better thing to do in this case is to warm it rapidly in running or circulating water at only room temperature, never hot. And if that isn't possible, then they should put the frostbitten area near a warm part of their body. And as I said, if blisters appear, this is a severe form of frostbite, and they should get in touch with the doctor. If that's not possible, cleanse the affected area with water and either soap or a mild detergent. Rinse thoroughly and blot it dry with sterile or clean towels. Do not break the blisters. If fingers and toes are involved, separate them with dry, sterile gauze. Do not apply other dressings and wait for medical aid. If apparently the ambulance services are running better in the suburbs than they are in the city, and they should take care of this. Now, if it's an overall body thing, if somebody has been trapped in a stalled car or something like that, the finest thing they can do is be immersed in warm water in a bathtub only. They should not have any contact with sheets or anything else until they can get hold of an ambulance.
There are about 1,000 people marooned at this time at the Marine Midland Center at Maine and Seneca. They are mostly employees, and they will spend the night there. Don't worry, they have enough supplies for 3 days. Here are some additions to shelters. Protestant Home for Children at Niagara and Jersey is open for emergency shelter. Frederick Douglass Towers on Clinton between Jefferson and Spring is opening its community room for emergency shelter. And one more story, this one coming from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Pennsylvania Governor Milton Schaap has activated the Pennsylvania National Guard to help out in that state's snow and energy emergency. Schaap today issued a proclamation ordering the National Guard to provide assistance where needed. KBAK weather after this.
Skiers save up to 40% at the Port of Sports. They're still receiving late arrivals of major manufacturer ski equipment that must be sold. So the Port of Sports is having a special two-day only mid-season sale, tomorrow and Sunday only. Get famous name two-piece color-coordinated ski suits, stretch pants by Edelweiss with sweaters to match, T-necks, gloves, bib warm-ups, and hats all at bargain prices. 100% down parkas and vests by Picanta, Pacific Trails, Carvel, Jones, and Black Bear at savings of up to 40%. For 2 days only, you can get Rossignol ST comps and ROC comps, marked down to just $164.95. Or K2 244s and shorts, now only $139.95. Other bargains on Rossignol, K2, Olin, Head, Hart, and Fisher skis. Boots by Hansen, Nordica, Humanic, Scott, Lang, and San Marco at savings of 20 to 50%. Accessories are available at Super Savings, too. On Harlem Road between Maine and Kensington in Snyder, the Port of Sports, for 2 days only. Tomorrow from 10 to 6, Sunday from 10 to 3, the Port of Sports.
On Elmwood near Hurdle, land at 1021 Broadway, there are a couple of old factory warehouses. Now, they're not much to look at, inside or out. But if you want to buy fine furniture at fantastic savings, that's where you want to be. Where? FWS, of course. Right now, the FWS Fire Sale offers savings of 20, 60, 70% on brand name furniture. Brand names you just won't believe. Thomasville, Simmons, Lazy Boy, and dozens of others. Quality furniture at fantastic savings. Because FWS bought out every single piece of furniture from an Indiana store. A fire in Muncie.
Fire trucks and ambulances are having a tough time getting through the heavy traffic and snow. Buffalo police cruisers are responding to emergency calls. All police departments are backlogged. A pregnant woman in Lackawanna began labor, and the clogged roads hampered the rescue mission. Many people who were stranded sought relief centers. Most churches, firehouses, and public buildings are filled with people tonight. The Main Place Mall is also giving shelter.
Four. You bowled last storm, did you not?
No, no, I was home.
Oh, you watched it? You were
the
lucky
ones right now, sure.
Who do you want to say hello to?
Oh, I got a long list. Let's say hello to my wife, Linda, and my parents, Arlene and Tony, and my mother-in-law, Barbara, and my brother-in-law, Jerry, and my brother, Don and Cindy.
I hope you met
all
that.
My friends and relatives. Hi, Sitsy, Lottie, and Jean. Hope you're feeling better.
Are you going to get us pin pals?
Yes.
You know how the game works.
Yes, sir.
You understand?
Yes.
Okay, let's make some money for St. Jude's and for your pin pal, Mr. and Mrs. Peter DeSalio of Fiddler Road in Mount Morris, New York. In case you're just joining us and wondering what is going on, obviously our bowlers couldn't make it through the snow tonight, so we have volunteers from our Eyewitness News team bowling tonight for charity. And we have another split. Oh, it went down. It went down. A wiggle and down it went. So Joel is going after the remaining pin. Looking for his spare. Didn't make it. But you got the red pin, Joel. You want to come over here? The red tag pin, I should say. What bowler number were you? You're five. He's five? Number five. I've learned your trick. Thank you, Joel. Okay, we're going to just remind everybody again that now Here's the address. If you would like to be a pen pal, just copy this address down, put it on a postcard, and mail it into Bowling for Dollars. There's the post office box number, and your card will go in the drum. Don't forget, we're going to fill up the drum again on Monday. Now we need our meat. Our next bowler, $20. $320 for sure? Alan Harris.
He's awful scared, man. Maybe you better try to coax him out.
Help him out.
Do it. I'll try.
Yes, and it is the weather outside, Alan. I saw that report you did. What did you call it?
Weather outdoors.
Outdoors.
Outdoors is also outside.
That's right. I forgive you.
All right.
You've got a list, too.
Of course I got a list. I got half of Don Elhart's list, and I don't know who these people are. Now, got to say hello to my little daughter, Lori, of course. She's sitting at home. She's nice enough to give the television set to my wife to watch this tonight. She always watches TV at this time.
Yeah, she always watches Bowling for Dollars this time, doesn't she, Alan?
Well, she watches TV at this hour. Got to say hello to my neighbor, Sam, and Rosemary, and neighbors on the other side, Pat.
Dollars, pin pal, is Marvin Goodman, Box 53, Port Gibson, New York. Alan Harris is our bowler. Our pin pal, Marvin Goodman, Box 53, Port Gibson, New York. And the money will be split between Marvin Goodman and St. Jude's. Should Alan get a jackpot? Oh. Ooh, we had a 9 and a wiggle, 8 and a wiggle. We got one left. And he did get the red tag pin.
Emergency. And this is all in capital letters. Emergency. Travel only. Now from KB News, here's Henry Brock.
Here's a road report for our 8 Western New York counties. All Erie County roads are heavily drifted and impassable. Niagara County reports the entire county has been declared in a state of snow emergency. All roads are closed to vehicular traffic except for emergency vehicles. New York State I-90 has 2-foot drifts and disabled vehicles. Orleans County, all roads are blocked due to blowing and drifting snow. Genesee County, entirely in a state of emergency. All roads are impassable. Wyoming County, all roads are closed. The entire county is closed. Chautauqua County, all roads impassable due to disabled vehicles and blowing and drifting snow. Allegheny County, all roads are open. Hazardous driving conditions now exist. No unnecessary travel is advised. Cattaraugus County, zero visibility. Some roads are partially blocked due to blowing and drifting snow. And Route 17, that's the Southern Tier Expressway, open. Zero visibility, caution, no travel is advised throughout this region, John.
Okay, Henry, thank you very much. More cancellations as we get them.
A smile can wake the sun up to what your world could be. And with every brand new moment, you're alive, you're feeling free.
Yes, Mrs. Buffon.
I just wanted to say that I think you're doing a beautiful job and that you're kind of holding the city together, I think. There'd be a lot more people panicking and everything if we weren't able to listen and know what was going on.
Well, Mrs. Buffon, we've been ridiculed by some people in the community for doing what we are doing, but we don't want anybody to get the wrong idea. WJJL is here tonight to help.
Well, you're certainly doing that, and I certainly don't feel you're doing any ridiculing. You're It's been fabulous the way you've all been working at it.
Well, we're pretty busy guys right around now.
Yeah, well, I'm sure that there's a lot more people than just me that appreciate it.
Okay. Listen, this is Buffon. You have yourself a good night somehow.
Oh,
okay?
Yeah. Fine.
We appreciate it. Thank you very much, dear.
Right.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Bye now.
Bye now.
Thank you, Mrs. Buffon. That's nice. Makes you feel good. Okay.
All right. With me, I have on the phone live on the air who?
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, this is Mike Denise. I'm calling up the transportation office.
Yeah, hang on just a second. Doug, will you turn that pot up just a little bit, please? Thank you. All right. You want to give that to me again?
Yeah, this is Mike Denise. I'm calling up from the transportation office.
Yes, sir.
We got about 50 people here from off the road and city employees. And we got another 50 that's in the motor repair over there. And the only thing we have here is just coffee. And we've been here since about 2 o'clock. We're going on 5.5 hours, and we're kind of hungry.
Okay, and where are you located, fellas?
Porter Newer, between Porter and Packard, right next to the telephone company.
Okay, you're right next to the telephone company on Porter and Packard. All right. Well, it's over the air now. You're on the air live right now at the present time. I think what we're going to have to do probably is see if we can contact the Red Cross people and see if we can.
Now, maybe because it's kind of a...
The Meadowlands.
The Cleveland Police downtown moving along just fine. We have the following closings. Factories, TRW, all Cleveland plants closed until Monday.
Highwaymen, 1961, those old cotton fields back home, 727, 2 degrees here at the Elmwood Street studios of WBEN. Kathy Gleason, School of Gymnastics, closed tomorrow. Kathy Gleason, School of Gymnastics, closed tomorrow. The Masonic 7th District bus to go to White Plains, New York, canceled for midnight tonight. And Reverend Roland Clark from Community Baptist Church in Lancaster called. All activities are canceled for tomorrow, including the fellowship supper. Cancellation of Sunday morning worship service at Delaware Avenue Baptist Church. Service.
The idol is nothing, and therefore meat that was offered to it is nothing. I'm not tainted by standing here in the midst of some of these idiotic symbols with which I violently disagree in order to tell you, beware of them. Think for yourself and find out whether or not there is a God.
Everything including their own special kind of after inventory sale.
We want to create an
215 rolls of wools, nylons.
Bishop Winkle says that there are about 1,270 customers affected. The failure happened at 6:39 p.m. and officials have no cause for it as yet. The affected runs from Broad Street to 21st East and West, and from Fisher to Long.
Road, if someone can pick them up in a four-wheel drive. Somebody called before and asked what to do in the situation if the lights go out. My father called me up. You know, we're not thinking too straight tonight. First thing you want to do is get a flashlight, right? Second thing you want to do is get some candles, right? Or a gas lantern or whatever. And if there happens to be somebody in your neighborhood with a fireplace, go to their house and bundle up in front of the fireplace, okay? So those are three suggestions you might want to take in hand.
And another thing, too, is that even though the fact that it's an emergency, a lot of people might be running an extra bunch of lights, you may be running extra heaters off of your electrical circuits in your home. Another thing you might do is check out your fuse boxes to see if you haven't blown a fuse. It might not be power lines. Make sure you check to see that you can rectify the problem in your home first before you try and contact the power company. If your fuses are not blown, then it is you have a problem with electricity and power coming into your home. So first, if you do lose power in your home, make sure you check out your own home first. Check your fuse boxes, get a flashlight, or get a candle and go on down into the basement. Or if you have to bundle up and go on outside for a couple of minutes and check your fuse boxes and see if they're all right on the outside. Then, and only then, call the power company. Also, if you can find somebody who is within walking distance of your home who may have power, go on down and check them out first. If not, then we suggest that you get a lantern lit or you get a candle lit, and make sure that if you are going to light flammable materials like a candle or a lantern, that they're not anywhere near anything that's going to catch on fire, namely curtains or any kind of paper products whatsoever. First of all, let me run down people who are stranded once again without any food. Those are people at the sanitation department at New Road out on, I believe it's near Packard. Is that what the fellow said?
Between Porter.
Between Porter and Packard. Also, some people stranded at professional ambulance at Pine and Packard. No food or drink or blankets, and also no room to sit down. People are stranded in the Summit Park Mall at the Sears store, but they've got a place to stay. They have nothing to eat. And that just about wraps up for people who are stranded right now.
Okay, I've got... note that 9147 Buffalo Avenue area, the area around 9147, the electricity is off and there isn't any heat in that vicinity. And I had one here that I wish I could... Oh, okay, here it is. If you have your power off at 66, in the area of 6648 Akian Road, those are all nurses. I got them all together there. 6648 Akian Road, in that area. If you are your electricity is off and you have no heat, give these people a call, 625-8332, and you can go on over there and stop in and get warm. They don't have any electricity, but they do have heat. So they either have gas or they've got...
Okay, 1560, Monte Clouds, Jura. We could stand some sunshine right now, huh? At 7:33, and let's see, I got a message stuff I want to pass along here. First in, let's see, if anyone knows the whereabouts of Larry Salvatore, he's been missing since 12:45 today, and could you please have him call his parents? Well, we're going to do our best. Larry, if you're listening, or anybody knows where Larry is, they've seen him since 12:45 today, give us a call. We'll try to pass along. Larry, if you're listening, please call your folks. So, Shirley Hermans has been missing since 5 o'clock this afternoon. His boss just called him. Like, anyone who knows Shirley's whereabouts to let him know that they have the facilities to pick him up. If it's not, it's okay, and that's all right. But in any event, please show your these people again.
Excerpt from Act 2 of Copeta, the Mislik of Leo Delib, orchestral suite from On, conducted by Ernest Ansonet.
Mr. and Mrs. Lester Miller, Mr. Woodward, Sonny Mowers.
Top story at 7:35 from the WQXR newsroom. At the request of Mayor Beam, the New York Board of Health has declared a citywide emergency because of the dwindling supplies of natural gas. News headlines from the New York City Ballet. Tomorrow at 2 at the New York State Theater, and evening's waltzes to music of Prokofiev, Webern's episodes, Tipsy's Afternoon of Fawn, and Ravel's In G Major.
And to the police departments in the area to see what the situation
and now,
is.
Now, where the music came from. Comments about music from Finnair. I'm Duncan Kearney. Of all Finland's great musical figures, perhaps the most poignant is Heikki Suolahti. Like Mozart, he showed amazing talent as a very young boy, and threw his energies into writing concertos, a ballet, and opera, and his best-known work, the Sinfonia Piccola, Little Symphony. But his heartfelt music promised the greatness that was not to be. For Suolahti died in 1936. The age of
for what
16.
Reason, I don't know anything about
still,
it.
Still, his music evoked the true spirit of Finland. Indeed,
give me some
all
confirmation on that. I tried to get
a
through
spirit
two hands.
You can experience
and,
on a Finnair tour, such as highlights of Scandinavia.
The best to try and get through to us, we would appreciate it. Get back to that and let people know what the situation is exactly at this time. We do have a phone line open, so they can give us a call right now, and we will take the information down from them. I'd also appreciate a call from somebody up here and let me know what the power situation is, too. That has been fixed before. Make that relate somehow to this problem at the mobile home park. So we've got still quite a few problems and situations we'd like to straighten around, a lot of personal situations, and feel free to call us. That's what we're here for at this time, to help you out, to help the community out, and we're going to hang in at least until 8 o'clock tonight and maybe after that too. We're going to have to just wait and see how the situation stacks up. And it's getting to the point. I said this before, where we thought most people would be off the roads, but we have seen lights now and again go up and down the fourth section road, just down our long driveway away from us. So there are people that are still attempting to be on the road. A while back, I saw an ambulance and I believe some sort of other emergency vehicle on the fourth section road. Check into that. We've got our thing points. We have to keep our eyes up for it. Well, I'm back around for quite a while, and I think we'll be on here at least until 8 o'clock and probably sometime after that as well.
Okay, Ron, thanks a lot. I'll let you get back to work. I'd like to run down some of these, all these personals that we have gotten in again. People looking for friends and relatives. Judy Christopher, your family, I guess, would appreciate a call at 589-9573. To let everyone know that you're all right. Now, folks, in calling in these personals, if people have called you back or they are okay and they're safe, please give us a call back so we can tell our listeners and we can cancel off so we don't keep repeating it. Also, Charlene Ellison left home now over 6 hours ago, and she hasn't been heard of since. If you're listening or anyone knows where she is, could you please call home? And if anyone knows where Albert Prusa is, or if he's listening, Persia, okay, thanks. Where Albert Persia is, or if he is listening, could you please call home and let everyone know that you're okay? In addition, Craig Gill left with his truck about 5 hours ago, and his family and friends haven't seen him since. He may be using a CB radio, so if anyone has talked to Snoopy, please tell him to either call Al or call at home. Also, folks are looking for Avis Porter. Avis, or if anyone knows and has seen of Avis lately, could you please call 659-8141? Let's see, what else have we got? Also, if anyone knows the whereabouts of Larry Salvatore, he's been missing since about 12:45 today, could you please have him call, call his parents and Larry if you're listening, call your phone. Shorty Humant has been missing since 5 o'clock this afternoon. His boss called, and would like anyone who knows Shorty's whereabouts to let him know that they have facilities to keep him. Also, if he's settled, that's fine, but in any event, please, Shorty, call either your wife or your boss. In addition, a number of people are stuck at Basil's restaurant. Apparently, either they were eating there or due to the tractor-trailer blocking the road. These people are stranded there. These are Hamlin, Kendall area people. Mrs. Robert Porter, Mr. and Mrs. Lester Miller, Mr. Woodward, Sonny Mowers, Mr. Sale, and Helen Babcock. These are all folks stranded at Basil's. They are safe. We're all right. We wanted to pass that message along to their family and friends. Also, a member of the Brockport ambulance crew is available at the Stage 16 at Brockport State for first aid or treatment of frostbite if it is needed. Call Larry Herman at 395-4558 or apartment 8411. Okay, so if anyone is down by Stage 16 and they're in need of first aid or treatment for frostbite, if you need it, call Larry Herman. The number again is 395-4558. Or he's in apartment 8411. Once again, folks, we'd like to remind you, please give us a call if you're looking for somebody, if you can be of help to anyone. I want to get back, just mention quickly, two snowmobilers are available for your assistance. If you need them, call Bill Rusby at 637-9341. And if you have any information concerning anything or you're missing someone, please feel free to give us a call. Telephone number 637-3930 and 637-3941 and the Orleans County area 638-8141. Okay.
Make sure that's right.
Yep. 8141. 741 BK1560 checking the forecast. Blizzard warning is continuing all through tonight. We're going to get the snow. We're going to get the winds. We're going to get everything that goes along with it all through the night. Things will let up slightly Saturday. 15 to 30 mile an hour winds. Snow is going to continue low tonight, 5 to 10 below. It is going to be continued cold with flurries again all through the weekend. Once again, if you've got a problem, you're looking for someone, or else you found them, give us a call. 637-393-0638-8144. This time
by a total of $4.8 million, $3.6 million for the DOT, and $1.2 million for Buffalo. But
Forecasters predicting weekend weather direct from the North Pole. The natural gas shortage took on emergency proportions in the state today. An estimated 100,000 workers were told not to come to work at industries closed by the crisis, and commercial operations using natural gas began to feel the squeeze on their supplies tighten. A Niagara Mohawk Power Corporation spokesman said it's too late to keep the factories and schools open. The company has told its 500 industrial customers that until late Monday it will supply them with only enough gas to prevent freezing. Despite Governor Kerry's announcement of a natural gas state of emergency last night, State Energy Office has taken no action to reallocate fuel or force public offices and schools to close. The spokesman said the infant office is
calling the station, calling the station to tell us that they're okay and getting along fine and getting to know their fellow employees maybe just a little bit better. We had an earlier report on that I'll repeat. 600 employees of the Bethlehem Steel office buildings in Lackawanna are spending the night in the offices. 2,500 Bethlehem Steel employees in the plant are also spending the night in the plant. 1,800 employees at the Ford stamping plant in Woodlawn are spending the night there, and I understand they're working overtime. So, it's a chaotic situation indeed, but...
You know, Jim, it never occurred to me, but that might be a drawback to be stranded at work, because people can say, well, as long as you're here, would you mind doing this?
Isn't that what Bob Harper said to you a little while ago?
That's kind of how I got on the radio tonight. Yes, between 7 and 9. Thank you, Jim.
We belong together.
You and WKBW, Buffalo.
I mean, yes, as long as you're here.
Boston all alone.
In a state of emergency. But we'll keep you abreast of all the information coming to us this evening. We once again urge you to call us if at any time you have a problem that we feel we can help you out with. Our number is 637-3930 or 638-8144 here at WWBK. We'll do our best to help you out. We'll tell you once again at this hour that we are staying on now going into our fourth hour of time that is past our norms during the month of January. We are normally sign off at the hour of 5 o'clock. However, under special provisions of the Federal Communications Commission, we are able to stay on the air after our normal sign off in emergency conditions. We feel this is an emergency condition for those of you in our listening area. We are doing our best to keep you attuned to all the information that we possibly can and get it passed along to you as quickly as possible. Steve McKay has been on working now for some, I think it's about 6 hours, Steve, and I've been here since early this morning, around 6:30 or so. It's been a long day, and we're doing our best, and we hope that you will put up with some of our stuttering and some of our slurred words. We're going to stay with you as long as we possibly can and as long as we feel the situation warrants. Steve, that's it for a look at news now, and of course we'll be passing along to people more information on the weather conditions and so forth as it becomes available to us.
Okay, thanks a lot, Ron. First, let's go through to the personals first. These are people who have not been seen at some time, and let me pass those along to you right now. If you've seen or heard from these people at any time, please call the numbers that we have here. Charlene Ellison left home to go to the supermarket. Right now it's going on her seventh hour, and she hasn't been heard of since. If she's listening or if anyone knows where she is or has seen her in the last 7 hours, please have her call home, or you please call here at BK.
Hey, man, this is the last time we buy tires from Sanford and Son.
Where Persia is, or if he is listening, could you please call home and let everyone know where...